Tina Tamar.
And we're the new hosts of the Soccer Sam Show. We are.
We are.
Girl. We've recently received a lot of letters, calls, and emails
regarding the U.S. national team versus the Ravens. So let's show it again.
All right. Let's go to Megan.
Hi, this is Megan Hanschak at the Soccer Shack in Brighton, New York. We have a very special Soccer Sam Show for you today. The most popular team in the U.S. has come here to Rochester to play. Now let's go to Soccer Sam for some interviews.
Soccer fans, now we're with Jenna Klugel. Jenna, this is your first time here with the national team. Tell me about it. How's it feel?
It's great. It's awesome. It's fun playing with all these players that I've watched over the years, so I'm having a good time.
Now, where are you from?
Minnesota.
Yeah? Yep. ODP program?
Yes, ODP. Yeah.
So you strongly believe that. So all those little girls that are watching out there, that's the way to get to this level?
Yep, yeah. Definitely.
We are now with Sarah Whalen. U.S. Women's National Team. Sarah, you were on the Soccer Sam radio show, and I tried to fix you up with someone. Remember that?
Yeah.
That's me, the wacky one here.
I remember you.
Tell me about it. Tell me about your experience with the national team.
Well, it's been a lot of fun so far. I mean, I've been pretty successful. I've been here pretty consistently, and I'm enjoying myself. I'm getting better every time I play.
We're with Tracy Dukar now. Tracy, now, didn't you have another name last year, a couple years ago?
Yeah, it was Tracy Noonan before.
What happened? What happened? You trying to protect the innocent?
No, I got married in April.
Beautiful. Congratulations.
Mm-hmm. Things are good.
So how long have you been with the team?
For a year and a half now.
How many caps?
10.
10, wow. So how does it feel to be traveling around the country and being like a celebrity?
It's a lot of fun. Yeah, it's good to be playing in games again.
Soccer fans, we're now with Christine DeVert. Christine, you got to tell me now. You know, 99's coming up. You're one of the rookies here. First tryout, right? Or first road trip, I take it?
Yep.
Yeah, how's it feel?
Good.
Now, I take it you were like an idol of Michelle Akers and Mia Hamm, and they were your idols. Now you're going to be playing with them?
Yeah, it's pretty exciting.
What school are you from?
I went to Santa Clara University 2 years, and then I finished at Pepperdine.
Soccer fans are now with Brianna Scurry, one of the greatest goalkeepers ever in America. What's up?
Oh, not much. We're trying to do a little soccer out here, hanging out, trying to get catch a little sun, catch a little rays, and hopefully get an outfit like yours.
Oh, no, I see. I love when you, like, dive post to post and all that. How long have you been doing the goalie thing?
I've been doing the goalie thing for about 7 years now, constantly. I mean, I started when I was 12, and I'm 25 now, but I've been doing the goalkeeper thing for about 7 years straight.
Christine, I got to tell you, I forgot to ask you this when I interviewed you on the radio show.
Uh-huh.
I'm, like, a huge, huge indoor soccer fan.
You are.
Did you play indoor soccer
yes,
for CISL?
Yes, I did. Yes, I did. Washington Warthogs.
Oh, that was why.
95.
I watched you play.
You did? So yeah, it was great. I loved it. Yeah. The guys are fun, different, but fun.
No, Meg, any of the guys?
Nah.
Come on.
I was chasing them the whole time. They were so fast.
So you're like a superstar here in Rochester. This is like unreal for us here.
Oh, it's great. I mean, it's awesome to be out somewhere new. I mean, where soccer's big, you know, it's just fun to come play here and meet everyone, see your show. Radio show, TV show, everything.
Soccer fans, one of the greatest coaches ever in America, Mr. Tony DiCicco.
Well, no, our focus is 99. You know, we're not world champions. We're just Olympic gold medal champions, and not to to put that down, because that was an incredible experience. But we want to regain our world championship status, and that means we've got to be better than we are today, and we've probably got to be better than we were last summer. So we got a lot of work to do.
So World Cup 99, I'm going to be there. We're going to do the thing, the gold medal, right?
All right.
And 1-800-KEEPER-1?
That's it, 1-800-KEEPER-1.
Tony DiCicco, you've seen him right here on the Soccer Sam Show, my man.
Thanks, Soccer Sam.
One of the greatest coaches ever in America.
Oh,
I'm so excited. Can I just kiss your cleats?
Alex, you got to tell me, who's got the best rollerblades in town?
Locker Room.
Locker Room Sports?
Yes.
Who's got the best soccer stuff in town?
Locker Room.
Locker Room Sports?
Yes.
Who's got the best hockey stuff in town?
Locker Room.
Locker Room Sports?
Yes.
Who's got the best goalie stuff if you're a goalie and you want to be a goalie and you want to get the gloves and the jerseys?
Locker Room.
Locker Room Sports?
Yes.
I mean, the Locker Room's got everything. What's the name of the place?
Locker Room.
Locker Room Sports. You heard it from Alex. This kid knows. Look at the camera there. Locker Room Sports, Ridge Road West. Go see Alex there.
Whether you're congratulating the MVP on the playing field or maybe the one in your office, NARA Trophies can help you commemorate those special moments. NARA has a large selection of awards, including trophies of all sizes and a full line of wall plaques that you can customize. Family owned and operated for over 30 years, NARA continues their tradition of top quality workmanship at a reasonable price.
I'm Mike. For a personal and reliable service, call us at NYRA. We'll help you celebrate any occasion in style.
I guess I got your attention. Now I can interview you. Are you all right?
You know I'm a black belt.
Oh, wow. How's it going?
Good.
Yeah, you're like unreal. I mean, I love the hair. Can I touch it?
Yeah.
Oh, I love it. Now, listen, I hear you got this book coming out, Michelle Akers. I mean, tell me about it.
It's called Standing Fast, and I did it with JTC Sports and Tim Nash, and it's out August 1.
August 1st, Standing Fast.
Standing Fast.
So like Border Bookstore, Media Play,
you
know, all those places?
You got to order it directly through JTC Sports.
Okay, so we're going to get that number. We're going to have it on the screen later on.
There's an 800 number. It's through Soccer News. It's on my webpage, www.michelleakers.com. So if you hit me on my webpage, I can get you the number.
Cool. Now, what's the book all about?
It's about me. And about mostly about the past 5 years and being sick and winning the Olympics and losing the World Cup and overcoming injury and my faith, and it's a really good book, if I must say. I was real pleased with it.
So the faith got your back?
Yeah, for sure. I'm a Christian, and if I wasn't, I don't know, I wouldn't be here today.
Well, you look great out there, and I wish you the best looking. I just graduated from Hooked on Phonics, so I could read that book. So I'll read it.
Okay.
Call Mia Hamm. Can you say something for me?
Sure.
Can you just tell people out there how much you love the Soccer Sam Show?
Hey, come to the game. Check it out. Really fun.
Biggest star in America right now, Mia Hamm.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you very much.
No problem.
Thanks, man. Jeffy D, I go to interview Mia Hamm. You're talking to her for like 30 minutes. She wouldn't even talk to me. You took up all the time. What's wrong with you?
Well, you know, I had a long conversation with her. She's a real great woman, and she's doing a lot for soccer in this town, in this country. So I had a lot of questions to ask her, Sam.
Soccer fans, I'm now with Joy Fawcett. Wait, are you any relation to Farrah Fawcett? Because I'm Bosley.
No, but I wish.
You look a lot like her, but hey, you just had a baby 2 months ago?
Yeah.
I mean, I had a baby 10 years ago and I still haven't lost anything. I mean, how do you do it?
A lot of work.
Yeah?
A lot of work with a lot of help.
That's great. Now, how does it feel? I mean, you're like a not only a role model for young girls that love soccer, but now you're a role model for mothers that realize that, hey, not only can you be a mother, but you can go out there and play in a competitive league and national teams or what have you. It's great.
Yeah, you can do anything you want to do as long as you put your mind to it. Yeah.
How hard do you have to work after the baby to get back to playing weight? Playing fitness?
Weight's there. It's just the fitness. It's a lot of work. It takes about 6 months.
Yeah.
Are you a soccer fan? Can't get enough of the sport you love? Read Soccer America. Get the most soccer news from around the country and around the world. Call 1-800-335-GOAL to start your weekly subscription. You won't miss any of the big players with Soccer America, MLS, U.S. national teams, college, international, interviews with the pros, scores, schedules, insight, opinion, analysis, and more. Soccer America delivers total soccer coverage every week. Call 1-800-335-GOAL to start your subscription. Call 1-800-335-GOAL now.
Michelina's Italian Eatery, 2700 West Henrietta Road, 424-3040. Check them out. Lunchtime, dinner time, great Italian food. I love this place.
Hi, I'm Carrie, and this is Tina, and we're here at Tully's tonight talking to Malai. How do you pronounce your name?
You pronounce it Malai.
So, how did you get started in soccer?
I was around the age of 9 years old, and I went to go see a couple of my friends play. I never heard of soccer. I went to go see my friends play, like I said, and I fell in love with the sport after that.
Great. Did you play in high school?
Yes, I played in high school. I went to Flint Northern High School. I played my freshman, sophomore, and senior year. I didn't play my junior year because I took a little time off.
That's good. And what brought you to Rochester?
We played against Rochester this summer for the U.S. Open Cup. And after we played them, I guess I caught the eye of the coaches, and they invited me to come play here.
Do you like all the fans?
Yes, I'm really amazed at the fans. I mean, I've seen the team play on TV before. You know, you really don't get the feel of it until you're there.
Yeah,
and seeing,
it's amazing.
Seeing 11,000, 12,000 people, I was amazed, very amazed.
Great. And now they know how to say your name.
Yes, I hope they do.
Sorry about that. Well, come on down to Frontier Field and watch Malai play soccer.
When I was a kid, I used to love playing soccer and flying my kite so much that it didn't matter that my mom used to make me wear those dorky clothes. Well, I still play soccer and I still fly my kite, but now I've got some killer clothes.
Not your mom's clothes!
Great food, good times is our motto here at Tully's. Our menu is full of great food at great prices.
And the good times never stop at Tully's. Kids and adults love our game room.
If you're a football fan, don't miss our Monday night football parties. And Wednesday, kids pay what they weigh.
Hello?
Hello? 10 and under, please. We've got a free song and a Sunday for every birthday.
And Tully's has over 70 televisions. Yay! So if you can...
pitch it.
Punt it.
Putt it. Serve it.
Jam it.
Drive it.
Slam it.
Ride it.
Then try it.
Watch it here.
Tully's, 1225 Jefferson Road in Rochester.
Don't forget to listen to the Soccer Sam radio show. It's on Saturday mornings at 10:05 and lasts for 2 hours. Oh my, check it out, baby.
Hi, this is Megan, and we're back at the Shack. This special game was played at SUNY Brockport with, of course, my favorite team, the Rochester Ravens, playing the U.S. national team. And it was a sellout. What an unbelievable crowd. Now, let's go to some first half highlights.
there. Hello.
Where do you play right now?
Well, I played at Princeton this fall.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Who's your favorite national team player?
Wow. I don't know.
Mia Hamm? Come on.
Oh, sure. Of course, Mia Hamm.
Right. We got more soccer players here. Ladies, now, you play soccer, I take it?
Yeah.
All right. Now, are you excited about the U.S. national team being here?
Yeah.
Who's your favorite player? Tell me. You, who's your favorite?
I don't know. Mia Hamm. Yeah.
How about you?
Mia Hamm.
Mia Hamm. Mia Hamm. Oh, all right. Well, enjoy the game, all right? Wait. Look at her. I didn't ask her. Who's your favorite player?
I like April.
April?
Yes.
I like May. Look, they got the American flag, JC. American flag. Umbro. The official sponsor of the A-League. Oh, I like the haircut. I like it. Oh, you too. I like it. Oh, yeah. You having a good time?
Yeah.
Oh, you having a good time?
Hell yeah. It's awesome.
Look at this guy's a tough soccer player. Look, he plays with his leg all bandaged up. You're an animal. How you doing? What's your name?
Chris Shackles.
Who's your aunt?
Jill McCabe.
Jill McCabe's your aunt? She's not just a player. She's everything. She's everything in women's soccer. What's up, dude? Hey, guys, are you excited about the national team being here?
Yeah.
How about you? Look at the dude's got the gel working. Who's your favorite player?
Mia Hamm.
Definitely Mia.
Mia McCabe!
Baseball, basketball,
soccer, Rochester, Fort, Garden,
Cornell.
Come down and play.
Join the league. Are you good enough?
Rochester, Fort, Garden.
Sarah, I forgot to talk to you yesterday about one thing. I heard that you're one of the first models to wear the new Soccer Sam designer toenail polish. Is that true?
Yeah, that would be true.
Oh, look at she got the Soccer Sam toenail polish. All right, that's cool. It's available everywhere in the country, right?
Yeah.
Oh, you're so good. Now, tomorrow against the Ravens, are you going to do anything crazy or what?
We'll see. I don't know. You got to come out and see it, and we'll see what we all do.
Yeah, but, I mean, you know, no tattoos. I mean, you got to do something unique. I mean, pink, dye your hair like an orange or green. Can you do something crazy
like
that?
Yeah, I'm thinking about it.
Could
I'll find something, yeah.
All right, you'll do it.
Yeah.
All right. Soccer fans, now we're with Tisha Venturini. Tisha, I mean, I watched that beautiful goal. We had you on the Soccer Sam radio show. How does it feel to be like a legend?
I don't really know. Don't ask me. Ask some of these other guys. No, it's great. I'm just happy to be part of this team. I'm surrounded by the best players in the world and get to train and play and hang out with them every day. So I'm just happy.
Soccer fans, we're back with the D-man, Tony DiCicco. Tony, I forgot to ask you. Anybody here, like scouting out here in Rochester, anybody in particular we can talk about?
Well, it's an opportunity to see, some of the elite players in the USISL. One player that's been with us before in training camp, hasn't had a chance to play internationally, is Laura Martin. She plays for the New York team. So Laura and some other players we'll take a look at. And also we're going to be looking at some of our young players playing in the game tomorrow. But I think it's an opportunity to see some players I don't normally see. So thanks, S-Man.
Hey, you know what? I interviewed all the rookies, you know, they got the privilege to be interviewed by me, and I'm going to hang on to that tape. So World Cup 99, I got their footage. So when they score a goal, they do something to the tackle. I said, I was their first interview.
You were probably the reason. If we win in 99, Soccer Sam, you are the man.
Oh, thank you. I'd kiss you, but I can't. It's a family show. Thanks.
Lizard Soccer Tips, sponsored by Marine Midland Bank, banking for the real world.
Hi, I'm Rudy Pikusinski of Buffalo Blizzard, here with a soccer tip on trapping. Trapping is a very important part of the game, which I think is neglected by many kids. The most important part of trapping is keeping the ball near you. This way, it's away from your opponent. You also want to use both your feet in trapping. Now, I'm going to show you one way to trap using the inside of your foot. When receiving the ball, you want your foot to give. Right when you're ready to receive the ball, you want your foot to give. You want to use both your feet. It's very important to use both your feet. There are many different ways to trap a soccer ball, and that's just one of the ways to do it. So keep practicing. I'm Rudy Pikusinski of the Buffalo Blizzard. Keep kicking.
Thanks, Rudy. Soccer fans, December 6th, the Buffalo Blizzard play the Kansas City Attack featuring Nate the House Hauser, Kevin Ketters, all our favorite Blizzard players. You got to come there. And you hockey fans, Ted Nolan will be there. They're doing a tribute to Native Americans, and Ted Nolan will be there December 6th, 855-4400. I'll see you there at the marina, baby.
At SoccerSam.com or send us a fax to area code 716-254-3271 or call the Soccer Sam office at 716-259-KICK.
We're back at the shack. You guys were at the game the other night?
We sure were. Yeah.
Great players.
Those ladies can play.
Great. Let's go back to some second half highlights now.
How was it out there?
Scary.
Yeah? It was a lot of pressure?
Yeah, it was fun. It was really exciting. It's hard not to think of who the people are when you're running, when they're coming at you. But
not only that, 9,000 fans.
I mean, know, but I wanted to score.
Did you come close?
Yes, he headed it off the line.
All right.
I still can't believe it. That's all I can say. It's unbelievable.
Being a superstar in the USISL Women's League, what do you feel the difference is playing the national team compared to the league you're playing in right now?
These guys can certainly run all over the place. They're a lot more fit. They can run us up and down the field, and they're a little quicker on the ball. So, but it's good practice for us to get us ready for the national tournament.
So they're a little quicker and a little bit more in shape. But other than that, you know.
Other than that, they got a lot better names, too. You got Mia, you got Brianna.
Cool names.
We got some really cool names. We got some real simple names.
Come on, Megan's a hip name. I like it.
You like it, Sam? Oh, it's not like Soccer Sam, though. It's just Megan.
It used to be Skipper Sam. I had to change it.
How was it out there?
It was, at first it was scary, and then it was exciting. And then when I took the ball from Mia once, I was thrilled.
Isn't that one of your idols?
Yes, definitely. I think Kristen Lilly is now that I've met her.
How was it out there?
It was awesome. You know, just being out there was awesome. I loved it. Yeah, it's the best feeling. Just finished playing the U.S. national team. It's the greatest feeling in the world. Some of those girls are, you know, your idols. You just dream about playing with them. It was great. Jill got that all together for us. It was great.
What'd you say to me?
I said, is that orange outfit? So in case you get lost, someone can find you in the dark.
Well, we don't have a light on the camera, so I brighten up everything.
It's dusky out here, but you are standing out. I mean, more than most people out here.
How was it out there?
It was a great day to be a Raven. It was awesome. It doesn't get much better.
Did you expect this kind of crowd?
No. That was the most amazing part, was when we walked out to warm up and we looked and there was like millions of people. I mean, not millions, but there was millions of people. And they introduced the national team, and they got their round of applause, and then the Ravens were even louder, and we were just psyched.
Jill, I mean, you are the woman in soccer. I mean, 9,000-plus fans. We're going to get a pro stadium because of you, I think.
I hope so. And we better be able to play in it, too.
You're going to play in it, and we're going to get a pro men's league we have, a pro women's league. It's going to be huge. Women's World Cup, who knows? Julie, I won't bug you. Just keep on signing.
Oh, yeah.
Julie.
Oh, crazy soccer Sam.
How's it going?
I'm good.
Are you ready
for a beer.
Are you impressed with this Rochester crowd here, 10,000 fans?
Oh, yeah, they were great. Very impressive. We're coming back, we said.
You're going to come back?
Yeah, and I'm loving this weather. Good golf courses. Can't beat it.
Chrissy, great goal.
Sammy, what's
great
up?
Goal.
Thanks.
I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
Oh,
it was your interview the other day.
You know, but I wanted a cool celebration.
Yeah.
You got to do something crazy when you score.
Crazy next time.
All right, promise?
Promise.
All right.
We're going to get a pro stadium here. And we're going to get a pro team, and you got to come play with us.
Excellent, man. I'll be there.
You will?
Yeah.
If I can work it out?
Work it out. And you all have to watch Soccer Sam, because he's just awesome.
Thank you. That's me, right?
That's you.
Oh, thanks.
Hey, next week, highlights of the last Rhinos home games of the regular season.
And the Soccer Sam cam showing clips from the Rhinos road trip.
Hey, I was there.
You were?
Yes, I was.
Did they get you on Sam cam?
Yep.
How'd they do?
They played great in overtime, but they didn't win. But they won Sunday.
And that's all that counts.
3-1.
Anyway, join us next week here at Tully.
Monday night from 8 to 10 p.m.
And as usual, have a great soccer weekend.